you also knew you had to have somebody to really draw people to the label. Kids with a visual experience that played this hard rock music that would show he could think beyond the bubblegum pop and beyond the disco music or dance music at the time. And so this was a good way to start. And this was the band he put up in front of everybody when he started Casablanca and saying, this is the kind of stuff I'm going to be doing. If you don't like it, that's tough. This is the stuff I'm going to be doing. In fact, Warner Brothers, who was hoping to get Casablanca started, was very fearful about this because it's like, these guys are wearing makeup and the costumes and hey, you know, why can't we have somebody like the Eagles come out here or something? So they didn't care for it and it caused a lot of friction, but that's the way that Neil Bogart wanted to do it.
1974年2月、 KISS はデビューアルバムをリリース。期待したほどの売り上げにはならなかったが、同じ年セカンドアルバムをリリース。アルバムのセールスは振るわなかったが、 KISS の派手なライブパフォーマンスは話題になり始めていた。KISS のライブでは恒例となっているジーンの皮膚機。
I didn't. When we first started in New York City, before we went out on tour, our manager then, who's passed away by now, Bill O'Coin came in and we were sitting in his office and he said something like, which one of you doesn't want a Spitfire? What do you remember?
There was some magician who came in, who his name was something like Magico or Mazo, something like that. We had no idea. We were just coming to Bill's office for a meeting. And we come in and this man takes this pole with fire on it and he goes, and he scorched the ceiling of the office. It became black. And Bill looked at us and said, okay, who wants to do this?
No, I think it was who doesn't want to do it, and all you guys raised your hand, and I didn't want to do it, and I thought he said, who wants to do it, so I didn't put my hand. He said, okay, you're spitting fire.
But he was willing to go with it, and so he started doing it on a regular basis in the big time, of course, with the Academy of Music show in 73, where it's like, I'm going to show these people I'm going to spit fire. And the way Gene tells this story is that he spit fire, and he's standing there, and he doesn't even realize that he'd accidentally set his hair on fire. So he's standing there with flames starting to come from his head. Somebody puts a towel over and said, doesn't know what's going on. Like, you were on fire. And so people are cheering and stuff. And he's like, yeah, they're cheering because I'm going to kill myself on stage. And they'd never seen that happen in front of them at a live show.
Circus, no.
But now we're in the Psycho Circus.
and also the Psycho Desk, but
said,
that's another
story. Anatawa Psycho Circus.
Anatawa Psycho Circus. No, we didn't join the circus, but there was a lot of practice, and even in concerts, I would get burned. The hair would catch fire and go down the neck. It's not, you should not do it.